Good morning, one and all. In this video lesson, we are mainly going to discuss essentials of indicating instruments. Actually, these measuring instruments will be measuring the quantity of which we are measuring. So, in this, electrical measurements are mainly classified into two types. Those are the absolute instruments and secondary instruments. And these secondary instruments are further classified as the indicating type instruments, recording type instruments, and integrating type instruments. So in that classification, we are focusing on indicating type instruments. To work indicating type instruments, what are the main requirements? What are the different tasks required? And how we are getting those tasks, which assembly we are using, which one is better, what are the consequences of using concerned systems, we are going to discuss detail in this video lecture. In the previous class, we have started our discussion regarding electrical and electronic measuring instruments. So in that we have seen the importance of measurement. So what is the requirement, where we are going to take the measuring process, and what are the basic terminology which are involved in measuring instruments, like accuracy, precision, resolution, sensitivity, error, we have discussed. So accuracy is nothing but the degree of closeness of quantity which we are measuring with respect to the true value. With respect to the true value, how much the measured value is closer, that we have discussed. And the precision is nothing but the reproducibility. The repeatability of an instrument is precision. And coming to error, error is the deviation, that is the difference between the measured value and true value. Difference between the measured value and true value is error. And coming to the resolution, resolution is the minimum change in input which will cause change in output is a resolution, and the resolution has to be minimum. And sensitivity is the ratio of change in output with respect to change in input. So how much change in output we are getting for a given change in input will be the sensitivity. So these terms we have discussed in the previous class, very important, that's why we have revised once again. And we have gone through the classification of instruments, like indicating type, recording type, and integrating type. So we have seen the examples of those classification also, and we have seen main differences between the absolute instruments and secondary instruments. So absolute instruments are standard instruments, so mainly it will be used in laboratories. So that measuring process will take somewhat time in absolute instrument. So there we have to measure the value, and we need to do some mathematical operation and for calculating the exact reading. And secondary instruments are calibrated one. So once the meter is connected to the measurement, automatically it will indicate the value. So in all laboratories and practical applications, generally we are going with the secondary type of instruments. Where in standard laboratories, for accurate measurements, we are going with the absolute instruments. So in this today's topic, we are mainly focused on what are the different requirements for proper operation of indicating instruments. To ensure proper operation of an indicating instruments, what are the tasks required? So those will focus in this today's video lesson. And those tasks are mainly a deflecting torque, controlling torque, damping torque. deflecting torque, controlling torque, damping torque for preparation of operation of indicating instruments. So these three torques are very essential. Mainly this deflecting torque will move the pointer from the initial position. So normally the measuring instruments designed such that the pointer is staying at the minimum value. Generally it will stay at zero, whether it is a voltmeter or ammeter, it will stay at zero. And whenever we are applying some measuring quantity, then accordingly, depending on the value of measurement, the pointer will move from zero to according to the quantity we are measuring. So it will deflect. And the second one is, once the pointer is moved from its initial position, there is no opposition, then it will continuously move. To oppose the deflecting of pointer, we are providing the controlling torque. So different arrangements are provided. How this controlling torque will be provided, we are going to see. Generally the gravity control method, and another one is by using spring control method. So different instruments will use different types of method according to the requirement. And second one is controlling torque, and the last one is damping torque. So once the pointer is moved from its initial position, and because of controlling torque at one steady state point, when this deflecting torque is equal to controlling torque, it will stay at that final position. But because of these two torques, it will oscillate at that point. It will not come into the rest, it will oscillate at the final deflection point. So for the observer taking reading, it will be difficult. So to reduce the oscillations, we are providing the damping torque by using different means, like air friction damping, by using fluid friction damping, by using eddy current damping. We are providing the damping for the measuring instruments. And how these will work, we are mainly focusing this today's video lesson. Deflecting torque causes the moving system and pointer of the instrument to move from its zero position. It will cause the moving system, that is the pointer, to move from its zero position. And controlling torque, this controlling torque limits the movement of pointer and ensures the magnitude of deflection is unique and is always same for the given value of electrical quantity to be measured. The controlling torque limits the movement of pointer and ensures that the magnitude of deflection is unique and is always same for the given value of electrical quantity to be measured. And the last one is damping torque. The damping torque minimizes the oscillations of the pointer about final steady deflection and makes it steady. Damping torque minimizes the oscillation of the pointer about final steady state deflection and makes it steady. This is regarding damping torque. And coming to essentials of indicating instruments are these three torques. Deflecting torque, it is also called as operating torque. And the second one is controlling torque, it is also called as restoring torque. And the third one is damping torque. So these three torques are the essentials. The indicating instruments are those which indicate the value of quantity that is being measured at the time at which it is measured. Such instruments consist essentially of a pointer which moves over a calibrated scale and which is attached to a moving system pivoted in bearing. The moving system is subjected to the following three torques: a deflecting torque, a controlling torque, and a damping torque. So these three torques are the essentials for the indicating instruments to indicate a value of the given measurement. And deflecting torque is produced by making one of the magnetic, arc, heating, chemical, electrostatic, and electromagnetic induction effect. So by considering any one of the effect, the deflecting torque is produced, and it causes the moving system of the instrument to move from its zero position. So this torque will cause the moving system to move from its zero position. The magnitude of this deflection force depends on the value of electrical quantity to be measured. Magnitude of this deflection force depends on the value of electrical quantity to be measured. The method of producing this torque depends on the type of instrument. Next one is controlling torque. The magnitude of moving system would be somewhat indefinite under influence of deflecting torque. So once it is moved, there won't be any control, so that it will move continuously till the last point, unless the controlling torque existed to oppose the deflecting torque. It increases with increase in deflection of the moving system. Under the influence of controlling torque, the pointer will return to its zero position on removing the source producing the deflecting torque. So what this controlling torque will do is will move the pointer again from the value of indication to zero once the deflection torque is absent. So the function of controlling torque is to oppose the deflecting torque, and it will make the pointer to move to zero position, initial position. Without controlling torque, the pointer will swing at its maximum position and will not return to zero after removing the source. As just now we discussed, with the absence of controlling torque, once the meter is subjected to measurement, so it will move from zero to the maximum position. It will not indicate the value of measurement. And once the measurement process is completed, the pointer will stay at its maximum position and it will not come to zero, even though after we are removing the source. The pointer is brought to rest at a position where the two opposing forces, that is the deflection and controlling forces, are equal. Now whenever we are connected to the source, meter is connected to the source, the pointer is brought to rest a position when the two forces, that is the deflection and controlling forces, are equal. And coming to types of controlling system, the controlling systems are mainly two types: spring control system and gravity control system. So this is the spring control system. So here we are having two spiral springs. So it always keep the pointer at zero position. So here we are having a scale. Scale is not shown. So here we are having the scale. On that scale, the pointer will move. The function of the spring is always it will bring the pointer to zero position. And here we are having the spindle. The spindle will be arranged in the pivots. Spring control system. When the pointer is deflected, one spring unwinds itself while the other is twisted. So here we are having these two springs. So whenever we are connecting to a source, so one spring will be unwinded, opened, the other one is twisted. So this twist in the spring produces restoring, that is the controlling torque. So this twist in one spring will cause the production of controlling torque, which is proportional to the angle of deflection of moving system. Spring control method. In spring control method, the scale of spring control type instrument is uniform. So this we'll get from the formula. We are going to derive this. Here, if you are measuring a current, so let us take a PMMC meter, permanent magnet moving coil meter. By using that meter, we are measuring the current. When we are measuring the current, because of this deflecting torque, the pointer will move, and the deflection torque is directly proportional to the amount of current which is flowing through the meter. And because of this deflecting torque, the pointer will move on the uniformly graduated scale, and the scale will be uniform. And because of the pointer is moving, so one of the spiral spring is twisted and it is producing controlling torque. This controlling torque is directly proportional to the angle of deflection of pointer. So TC is directly proportional to theta. Controlling torque is directly proportional to theta. So when the pointer is coming to rest position, because of this source, depending on current, the pointer will move from some value, suppose 3 amperes. So at that final deflection point, this controlling torque is equal to the deflecting torque. TC is equal to TD, and therefore this angle is directly proportional to the current which is flowing through the instrument. Next one is gravity control method. So for providing controlling torque, so another method we are using. So this will be used in moving iron type instruments, generally gravity control method. We are going to discuss the meter, how it is working, in the next video lessons. So in gravity controlled instruments, a small adjustable weight is attached to the spindle of the moving system such that the deflecting torque produced by the instrument has to act against the action of gravity. So here we are attaching a weight to the moving system such that always the weight of this particle will be towards downside because of gravity. So in gravity control instrument, a small adjustable weight is attached to the spindle of the moving system such that the deflecting torque produced by the instrument has to act against the action of gravity. Actually, the weight has to point it towards ground, but due to deflecting torque, the pointer moves. Because of that movement of pointer, the weight will also move along with the pointer. But what the weight will always try to do, it will move towards the ground side because of action of gravity. Thus, the controlling torque is obtained. This weight is called control weight. Another adjustable weight is also attached. It's the moving system for zero adjustment. For the moving system to adjust zero, another weight is also attached, and that is used for balancing purpose. And this weight is called balancing weight. This another weight which is used is called the balancing weight. So this is the gravity control system, and here we are having the pointer. So initially this pointer will be at zero because of this balancing weight, and whenever we are connecting to the measurement, this pointer will move. This will be opposite by the weight W1, and when the pointer is moves accordingly, this weight also moves. So whenever it is at rest position, so this is the weight, and it will be having two components. So this one is the W1 cos theta, and this one is W1 sin theta. Two components will be there. So when the pointer moves, the controlling torque will be due to opposing force will be due to this W1 sin theta. Opposing force will be offered by this, will be like this W1 sin theta. So controlling torque will be provided due to weight component W1 sin theta. So normally this pointer will be at zero position. So if we connect this point meter to measurement, then it will move for an angle of theta. So when it is moves, the weight also moves. This weight component will be resolved into two components, W1 cos theta and W1 sin theta. For the moment of pointer will be opposed by this component W1 sin theta component. So this is regarding the gravity control system. In this, a small adjustable weight is attached to the moving system in such a way that in deflection condition, it produces a controlling torque. Weight W1 produces controlling torque, and W2 is used for balancing the weight of the pointer. So W2 will be used, weight W2 will be used for balancing purpose, and W1 will be used for providing controlling torque. Controlling torque. In gravity control method, the controlling torque TC will be equivalent to W1 sin theta into the length. And TC will be W1L sin theta. And from this equation, this TC will be directly proportional to sin theta. As we know, thus deflecting torque is directly proportional to current. At final steady state position of the pointer, the deflection torque will be equal to the controlling torque. So this I is directly proportional to sine theta. Actually TC is equal to TD, TD is equal to TC. So this I is directly proportional to sine theta. The scale of gravity control instrument is non-uniform because it is directly proportional to sine of angle theta. In the earlier case, by using spring control method, we got the expression as I is directly proportional to theta. So depending on change in current, accordingly the theta will be changing. Accordingly, theta will be changing according to the change in current. So that is uniform change. Uniform change, but in this case this current is directly proportional to sine of angle of theta. So that's why the gravity control type instrument will be having a non-uniform scale. Now we will see comparison between the spring control and gravity control. In spring control, increase in torque is much faster as the controlling torque is proportional to the angle of deflection. In gravity control, the controlling torque increases very slowly. Initially, the scale is cramped as it is proportional to the sine of angle of deflection. So here theta is directly proportional to current is directly proportional to sine theta. So that's why initially the pointer will move slowly. Hence the scale is more cramped at the lower end. In spring control, this type of instruments can be used in both vertical and horizontal positions. The user for the panel board meters and lab purpose. So we can use in both the orientations, in vertical orientation as well as in horizontal orientation. And coming to this gravity control method, these instruments can be used only in vertical position, thus suitable for panel boards only. For panel boards only we are using this gravity control method, so they are always in vertical position. They need not be leveled before being used. This kind of instrument should be properly leveled before being used. Otherwise, zero error may occur. So this spring control method of providing control system is costlier one. And this gravity control system is less cost. So by comparing these two, we understood that the gravity control system is not suitable for indicating instruments. This gravity control system is not suitable for indicating instrument, and it is not used in modern instruments. So we are using spring control method. So by this we can use in different positions, like horizontal position as well as in vertical position. Both the positions we can operate the meter. Next torque, essential torque, will be the damping torque. So as we have discussed earlier, when we have connected the source to the meter, the pointer will deflect. So the deflecting torque will move the pointer from zero position, and it will be opposed by the controlling torque. So at one steady state position, whenever this deflecting torque is equal to the controlling torque, at steady state position, the pointer will oscillate. Pointer will oscillate. In order to reduce these oscillations, we are using this damping tag. So in this damping tag, we have already seen that the moving system of the instrument will tend to move under the action of deflecting torque. But on the account of controlling torque, it will try to occupy a position of rest when two torques are equal and opposite. When this deflecting torque and controlling torque are equal and opposite, the deflection pointer will occupy at a rest position. However, due to inertia of the moving system, the pointer will not come to rest immediately but oscillates about its final deflecting position. So it will oscillate at a final deflecting position as shown in the figure and takes appreciable time to come to the steady state. So when we are connecting the meter, it will not show immediate reading. It will take some time. So to reduce the time, we are using this damping torque. To overcome this difficulty, a damping torque is to be developed by using a damping device attached to the moving system. Now we are going to see how to develop the damping torque. So what are the different methods we are going to use for production of damping torque? Now, the damping torque is proportional to the speed of rotation of moving system. That is, TV is equal to KV into d theta by dt, where KV is the damping torque constant and d theta by dt is the speed of rotation of moving system. Actually, in some damping systems like eddy current, there we are having the disc. The disc will be rotating along with the moving system and the damping torque is proportional to the speed of the disc. So accordingly, this torque will be equal to KV into d theta by dt, where KV is the damping torque constant and this d theta by dt is the speed of rotation of moving system. So mainly, so depending on the damping, damping systems are mainly damping factor. Depending on damping factor, the damping systems are mainly three types. One is underdamped. So oscillations will be like this. It will oscillate and come into the steady state position. So overdamped. So it will take some time to reach the final deflection position, and critically damped. So it will be correctly matched. The minimum time will be taken for getting the final deflection position. So these are the main. Another one is the undamped system. Depending on the degree of damping introduced in the moving system, the instrument may have any one of the following conditions as shown in above graph. Maybe underdamped or overdamped or critically damped systems may be used. So depending on damping torque, underdamped system. So in underdamped system, as we shown in this graph, the response is oscillating. So we'll oscillate to get the final deflecting position. And overdamped condition. And in overdamped condition, the response is slower. Response is sluggish and it rises very slowly from its zero position to final position. For reaching final position, it will take more time. In critically damped system, when the response settles quickly without any oscillation, the system is said to be critically damped. Here the oscillations are minimum and the response time will be very small. So these are the three conditions in tamping system. The tamping torque is produced by these three methods generally, and it is produced by these four methods. They are air friction damping and fluid friction damping and eddy current damping and electromagnetic damping. So by using any one of the thing, we can produce the damping torque. So we will choose the required thing according to the requirement. So here we are having the pointer on the scale. So it will be connected to a air compressed chamber. So when the pointer moves, this will be, the piston is moving inside to the chamber. And here compressed air will be there. Because of that, the pointer oscillations will be minimized. And the second method is, here we are having a control spring and here a vane is fixed. This is the pointer. So when the pointer is moving, and here we are having a control spring, it is moving, so that this oscillations will be minimized. In the arrangement shown above, light aluminium piston is attached to the spindle that carries the pointer and moves very little clearance in a rectangular circular air chamber closed at one end. The cushioning action of air on the piston damps out any tendency of pointer to oscillate about final deflecting position. This method is not favored these days, and the one shown in another figure is preferred. Second one is preferred. In the second method, one or two light aluminium vanes are attached to the same spindle that carries the pointer. As the pointer moves, the vane swings and compresses the air. The pressure of compressed air on the vanes provides the necessary damping force to reduce the tendency of pointer to oscillate. So this way the second method will operate. And another method of providing damping torque is by using a fluid friction damping. So here we are having a spindle. So this spindle will be attached to a disc which is placed on a damping oil. So whenever this instrument is moving, the spindle also moves inside a fluid. So because of this opposing force offered by the damping oil, it will settle at final deflection point quickly. And here we are having inside oil, we are having these two vanes, so that the efficiency of this damping system will be improved. So in this system, discs are vanes attached to the spindle of moving system are kept immersed in a pot containing oil of high viscosity. So inside that high viscosity oil will be poured. So in that a disc will be attached to the pointer. Whenever the pointer is moving, so this disc also moving. As the pointer moves, the friction between the oil and vanes opposes the motion of the pointer, and thus necessary damping is provided. The fluid friction damping method is not suitable for portable instruments because of the oil contained in the instrument. In general, fluid friction damping is not employed in indicating instruments, although one can find its use in Kelvin electrostatic meter, voltmeter. So full fluid friction damping is used in Kelvin electrostatic voltmeter. So this is the D current damping system, the last one. So here we are having the pointer. So this pointer is attached to a disc. So when the pointer is moving along with the moving system, this disc also moving, but disc is placed in between two electromagnets. So because of this movement of disc in electromagnets, damping force will be developed. So this is the spindle. The spindle will be attaching the disc with the pointer. So generally two methods of eddy current dampings are used. So in first method, as shown in figure, a thin aluminium or copper disc is attached to the moving system and is allowed to pass between the poles of a permanent magnet. As the pointer moves, the disc cuts across the magnetic field and eddy currents are induced in the disc. These eddy currents react with the field of the magnet to produce a force which opposes the motion according to Lenz's law. In this way, the eddy current damping torque produces the oscillations of the pointer. The second method is a coil which produces deflecting torque is wound an aluminium former. As coil moves in the field of instrument, the eddy currents are induced in the aluminium former to provide the necessary damping torque. So this is regarding the eddy current damping. So in this video lesson, we have mainly learned regarding the main essentials of the indicating type instruments. Those are the deflecting torque, the controlling torque, and the damping torque. The deflecting torque in an indicating instrument will make the pointer to move from the initial position, and the controlling torque will oppose the moving of the pointer. In the absence of deflecting torque, it will again make the pointer to come to zero. And the controlling torque in the indicating instrument will be provided by using two methods. One is by using spring control, and another one is by using gravity control method. In the spring control method, the controlled torque is provided due to stress of the spring. And with the gravity control method, the controlling torque is provided due to the gravitational force of the weight. And the last torque is damping torque. It is due to the inertia and the two opposing torques at final position. The two opposing torques will make the pointer to oscillate. So these oscillations are damped by the damping torque. Now we will attempt a small quiz on these essentials of this indicating instruments. The operating torque in an indicating instrument. Option A, deflecting torque. Option B, controlling torque. Option C, damping torque. Option D, all of the above. So which will make the pointer to move from initial position is the operating torque. So that is the deflecting torque, option A. In portable instruments, the controlling torque is provided by portable instrument. So we are using spin control method for providing controlling torque. The most suitable spring materials used in instrument are most suitable spring control method. We are using fast power branch springs will be used for providing spring control. For getting best results in indicating instruments, they are provided with underdamped, overdamped, critically damped, all the above. So generally it will be for optimum, it will be provided with critically damped system so that the response time will be minimum and the oscillations are also reduced. So critically damped system is preferred generally for providing damping torque. In gravity control method, if theta is the angle of deflection, the controlling torque is a function of option A sin theta, option B tan theta, option C theta, and option D 1 by theta. The controlling torque is directly proportional to sin theta, option A sin theta. So on this generally the frequently asked questions are: state the need of deflecting torque in measuring instruments. What is the purpose of controlling torque in a measuring instrument? Briefly explain a spring control system. Why damping torque is necessary in measuring instrument? What is meant by gravity control in an instrument? Explain how does it works. And this is the partial completion of this chapter 1, basics of measuring instrument. Please you go through these video lessons, and if you have any queries, please ask me, or you put the question in the comment box. So that we will discuss in the next video lesson. Thank you all of you for your patient listening throughout the video lecture. Thank you all of you.